Good morning, everyone. My name is Fabio the Turtle, and welcome to the Cobalt version 122c editor tutorial. The last video we did, we went through some triggers. I'm just going to show you a bit more trigger functions right now. Well, a few more trigger functions right now, because there's a whole bunch of them, and you can do a whole bunch of things. First thing I'll show you is the secret function. So, for example, I want to take some pickups. Here we are. So yeah, a bomb. And then, yeah, I'll just do that for now. So I want to set triggered action. There's a function called secret. And so if I set action to set the action secret, set this as bomb, I suppose. And set the target to bomb. If I press F5, you'll see nothing there. I have no bomb in my inventory. It's not there. However, I'll activate that trigger. So you'll say a button, trigger activate, set target, trigger one. It materializes in a thin air. We've all seen bombs work, haven't we, I'm sure? Very impressive. They used to be much more powerful in version 104, I think, 106. They were great. Anyway, so that's a secret function. It will actually work on terrain as well. So if I take a box or something, and set, I need to name the box first. Remember, if anything is to be activated by triggers, or if there's a or just interacted with other things, you always have to name it. So just the box, same deal, it's not there until I press the button. And then it's fully interactable. Triggers only work on the secret function only works on a one-shot basis, so you can't actually do it more than once. So that's the secret. If I want to move this box up here, and move the button over here, maybe, to give the box some physics, right? The purple ring, physics. Instead of the trigger action, I'm going to put physics activate. And then zero, indestructible, grouped, false, yada yada yada. There's no angle, unless you want to add an angle to it. Never mind. I just... deactivate the physics, maybe that'll have something to do with it. Righty, there you go. So there's no physics on that box, unless I press the button, then it falls out of the sky. Keep in mind that this is dangerous. So just be very careful for that, about that. If I set the rotation to it, nothing happens, apparently. I thought it would've, but hey, whatever. Oh, angle, here we are. Speed, set to 3, rotation, 6. I don't know. Let's just see what that does, huh? There you go. That's how to spin a tile, while it's in the air, and it's falling. Once again, keep in mind it's dangerous. So just be careful when you're working with stuff like that. What other stuff can we do with it? Destroy sequence, where is that? Intensity... Oh no, sorry. Destroy sequence. There's a delay, so we just set that to 0 or something. That'll actually destroy the box for us. That's pretty handy if you want to say, like, create a secret passage or make it seem like something's exploding. Which it pretty much did, really. I get rid of that. Set triggered action. You can, camera shake. Where is that? This is quite handy if you want to, like, yeah, simulate. Once again, simulate an explosion. So, right now it's, I'll just spawn tile sequence right now because I need to get rid of the, trigger or the target. So go back to up to triggered action. Camera shake. Zoom back out. I'll show you. Just wow. Okay. Maybe I need to turn up the intensity on it a little bit. Amplitude, millisecond. Same just to. So 1000 milliseconds make it 1 second. Change it to 2. Amplitude 4 goes all the way up to 40. So. See? Little mini earthquake. It tends to ease off and then ease back on. Say if I want to change this up to 40. Gets quite intense. Relatively a lot. So, yeah, just be careful with whatever it is you're doing. Like I said, it's handy if you want to simulate something going wrong inside, like a ship malfunctioning, or just maybe even an earthquake. It really all depends on up to you. It's really all up to you. Along with the physics activate, you can activate the deactivate the physical set around speed or set speed. There's a play sound sequence, which is the kind of cool for stuff, but you don't really need to worry about that right now, considering. Well, maybe you do, maybe you don't. If you want to recreate a tile, initial delay to zero, range. I don't think that's meant to have a range. Oh, right. I see the range is gone. Sometimes when you have something, it'll add its own little stuff onto the box, and then when you go back down, it'll keep it there. But don't worry about it. It's not part of that. It just kind of happens. So if we set this and then set that to box. We'll make it destructible too, so that way I can actually recreate the tile. So you'll see going on there. If I delete the box. Oh! Well. maybe it doesn't quite. Oh, I forgot to save. You see, this is why you always save. I forgot to. Well, it works as 3D tiles. One of the maps on the main game does. I'm pretty sure it works with 3D tiles anyway. So let's just try that again. Sensors and triggers. Triggered action. Recreate tile. This is on to box. So the target is box. Trigger activate. Set target trigger. Alright, let's try this again. No, it doesn't seem to want to work. Oh well. If you heard a little dinging sound, that means one of my other videos is done. so just don't worry about the recreate tile then. You can actually, I'm pretty sure there's a spawn tile sequence. I'm not sure. Damage, destructible activate, camera shake. Guess not. What else? We got remove items. Like, let's find the boomerang, shall we? Boomerang, here we are. Okay. So I've got the boomerang right now. If I press this button, boomerang's gone. I have no boomerang. So that's just handy if you want to take some items off your friend, off yourself. I can activate it when it's not in my hand. It only searches inventory, it doesn't search in-game stuff. So just be wary of that. When I first discovered it, I was hoping it would delete stuff that's outside on the field, but that doesn't want to seem to work. So yeah. What else we got? Set the bullet time. I won't really bother about that, but you can set the factor of the bullet time. One is max, such as like a chrono bomb. You know, the duration in seconds, this real seconds, I don't think it's bullet time seconds, and then the range of where it was. Because, so the range is 500 in origin of the trigger. And so as you move away, there's less bullet time. You set the weather to whatever. You set the temperature, wind, clouds, thunder, precipitation. Yeah. Now, sound alarm. This is pretty cool. This might also produce another crash. But yeah. So there's that. If any bots hear alarms, typically like the ninjas or the what are the names? The ninjas or the bots. They'll come running to the alarm. You can spawn an actor. This is pretty interesting. Let's just say fly robot. There's a little bug that causes it to spawn on a map on the map start. But I can spawn as many as I like. So you can use that as a sort of half spawner. Yeah, well, as a spawner, but not quite a spawner. You know what I mean. Spawn object. Let's say a spike. Typically, if you want to do this, personally, I just use the because there's a trigger on it now. So physics activate. Trigger, no target. Trigger action. Spawn object. Spike. So this is the list of what I can spawn. There's the initial speed of the object. Starts lethal for throwables. Typically you want that false unless you want, let's say, a spike to drop down or a grenade to drop down and be... Yeah. So let's hope that works. Maybe it doesn't quite seem to work. More super plug. Perhaps. Nah, doesn't seem to work. Oh well. So the object sequence. Let's try this. No delay. Hang on. Alright, this is going across them now. Oh, alrighty. So again, set the object sequence. Let's see, super plug. Let's try that. No. Alrighty, well, apparently you can set a target for that, so if it's at the target of the lights, then I guess maybe we'll spawn a plug at the lights. No, we just got a little bit of an error there. Okay. Let's not play around with that. Like I said, game's in alpha, still a whole bunch of things happening. Ooh, these are all adventure stuff. Oh, we don't want to touch any of that. Start music. Typically you want to sign this onto a map start function, so if I take secret base outside or something. If you want to sign it to a map start function, you can have theme music for the level, so just listen. Alrighty. See, if you want to sign that to a map start function, then you can start up having some theme music in your game. You got the teleport function. This is really good. So you notice that when you, if you want to teleport something, it always needs a target, and then it always teleports the player or the players. I haven't really experimented much with the double player, but it's pretty sure it only does the one, and teleports you to that target. There's a little bug with the buttons, because they're set on a... buttons can be set on a delay, or their trigger can as well. What was I saying? There's a way I got around this, I remember... That's right, yeah. If we set this to a small delay of like 0.15, I'm pretty sure it was. It'll teleport me before I can press the button again. Well, teleport me after the button's been pressed, because what was happening earlier was it'll teleport me as I was pressing the buttons. So that's why I kept pressing the button, because frankly I was paused in that action state, and then just kept pressing the buttons because I was still there, and yeah. So whenever you're teleporting someone with a button, either do it from the pressed action. Well, actually, no. Always use a trigger, because that way you can set a small delay to it. Just get rid of the target. Set trigger action. Toggle AIs. This is pretty cool, actually. Set that to 0, 0. Once again, these can all be accessed through the pressed action. I'm just using a trigger up here. Actors. Say we want a bot. There's that little bug again. Set his name to bot. So target bot. So this is on a toggle AIs, and it toggles the AI. He's now deactivated. Apparently he can still look at me, which is new, but if I toggle him back on... Yeah. And whenever something's been toggled, their light, their eyes turn off, and then you see that little buzzing on the top of their head. Frankly, I wish there was a disable function that wouldn't put the little spike here, because, well, then I'm making a map, and then it's just little things, because I want to kind of create a little room where they jump out at you, and then, yeah. Anyway. What else? And then trigger toggle. So, there's that. There's trigger mode events. This only typically works in a specialized game mode, so I'll be going through that later on. There's two more things I'd like to show: explosion sequence and effect sequence. So let's get rid of him. And you want to go down to here to, I think it was sensors and triggers? I think, oh, yeah, here we go. This node spawn. So it's set a spawner 1, set target, spawner 1. Says here, explosion sequence, set trigger action. So you've got the intensity, 0 to 5, well, 0 to 5. The delay, change that back to 0. Here it's got grenade. The explosion sequence, it always has to be linked to us. Always has to be targeted at a spawner sequence. You can't target it to anything else. It must be a little spawner. It only works once per go. So, there's that as well. You can use the, different buzz types. Different explosion types. Thermal grenade. Quite deadly. In fact, I think that's the old thermal function. Because it shouldn't just tore through my shield like that if it was a standard bomb. Oh, I'm so happy. Anyway, or the effect sequence. These are repeatable. So you got the amount, intensity multiplier, amount multiplier, change this to 4, and 0 delay. And the effect, let's have some electric sparks. Change off the delay, okay, wait, hang on. Do I need a delay? Delay for about 2 per spark, I suppose. You see? That's good for like a little bit of detail. You typically want to hook that up to a repeater trigger, so that way you can keep going instead of just every once you press something. But like I said, it's just good for little bits of detail. I'd say that's about it for triggers right now. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a good time.